Hello, and welcome to this video on ordering rational numbers. This video will show you how to list rational numbers from least to greatest or greatest to least. First, let's review the definition of a rational number. A rational number is any number that can be turned into a fraction with an integer in both the numerator and the denominator. 1/4 and 9/7 are examples of rational numbers. It's also important to note that 0.25 and 25% are also rational numbers because they are equivalent to 1/4, and therefore can be turned into a fraction that divides two integers. One of the easiest ways to order rational numbers is to turn them all into decimals and then put them in order. If we want to turn a percentage into a decimal, all we do is turn the percent sign into a decimal point and move it two places to the left. So 13% becomes 0.13. and 213% becomes 2.13. Turning fractions into decimals is a little bit more challenging, but still doable. To turn a fraction into a decimal, we first have to remember that the fraction bar means divide. This means that 3/4 is really the same as 3 divided by 4. So if we want to turn 3/4 into a decimal, we simply use long division to divide 3 by 4.
3 divided by 4.
4 can't go into 3 at all, so we add a decimal point and put a 0. Since we added a decimal point here, we need to add it to the top as well. 4 goes into 30 7 times. 7 times 4 is 28, so we write 28 and subtract, and we're left with 2. We then add another 0 and bring it down, and then see 4 goes into 20 5 times. 4 times 5 is 20. And when we subtract, we get 0. So 3/4 is equal to 0.75. Remember, some decimals continue for a really long time or end up repeating. So in these cases, it might be helpful to round to 3 or 4 decimal places. That should give you enough information to know where to place that number in a list. One other thing we need to look at is how to order square roots of numbers. You can turn them into decimals and order them that way, but that is usually pretty hard to do without a calculator. Another way is to recognize what two numbers the square root falls between. Let's look at an example so I can show you what I'm talking about.
The square root of 41.
41 is not a perfect square, so the way to estimate its square root is to find the two perfect squares on either side of it. The perfect square right below 41 is 36, and the one right above it is 49. Now we know that the square root of 36 is equal to 6, and the square root of 49 is equal to 7. So the square root of 41 has to fall somewhere between 6 and 7. Notice this doesn't give you a specific answer of what the square root of 41 is in decimal form, but it gives you a general location of where it would fall in a sequence of numbers, which is typically all that you need to put it in order. Now that we have reviewed how to order numbers, let's practice by putting this sequence of numbers in order from least to greatest. We are going to start by turning each of these into a decimal. Remember, to turn a percent into a decimal, simply change the percent sign to a decimal point and move it two places to the left. So 87% is equal to 0.87. We can figure out what 2/9 is by dividing 2 by 9. Remember, a fraction bar always means divide.
So 2 divided by 9, 9 goes into 2 0 times. So we add a decimal and put a 0, putting the decimal up here also. 9 goes into 20 2 times. 9 times 2 is 18, and then we subtract and get 2. If we add a 0 and bring it down, we get 20. 9 goes into 20 2 times, we get 18, subtract, and we get 2.
Notice that when we divide, we get 0.2 repeating. So for this exercise, we will round to 0.222. When we look at a square root, remember we want to look for the two perfect squares the number falls between. 78 falls between the perfect squares 64 and 81, which are the squares of 8 and 9 respectively. So the square root of 78 falls somewhere between 8 and 9. We can find 45 over 4 by dividing, just like we did with 2 over 9. So 45 over 4 is equal to 11.25. And 6.743 is already in decimal format, so we don't have to do anything with that number. Now all we have to do is put them in order from least to greatest. Before I do this, let me erase some of our scratch work so we have more room.
When we do this, we get
Now these aren't our original values, so to get our final answer, we have to change our decimal values back into their originals. If you were asked to put these numbers in order from greatest to least, you would follow all the same steps, except at the very end, order them opposite to how we did in this example. So 45 over 4 would be first, and 2 ninths would be last. And that's all there is to it. I hope this video on ordering rational numbers was helpful. Thanks for watching, and happy studying.